The largest fleet ever assembled in the Pacific, warships, aircraft carriers, and troop transports, moves on Tarawa Atoll, a speck of land in mid-Pacific. The start of the Battle of the Gilbert Islands. Invasion of Tarawa is under the command of Rear Admiral Hill and Major General Julian Smith of the United States Marines. In solemn reverence before the battle, these men of the 2nd Marine Division ask aid from God. Furious hammering by land and carrier-based bombers precedes the landings. The Gilbert Islands, seized from Britain by the Japs a few days after Pearl Harbor, are tiny but extremely important. At 5 o'clock in the morning, the Navy guns open up offshore. Fifteen 1,500 tons of Navy shells, 1,000 tons of aerial bombs, and now the Marines move in. To them falls the task of creating a bridgehead on the incredibly well-protected beaches. A square mile of land, but the toughest objective in the Gilberts. Navy guns fire over their heads at powerful Jap defense positions. Enemy guns on shore reply as the Americans and Japs become locked in battle. Many invasion barges are hit. Amid the smoldering wreckage and the shattered palm trees, the Marines inch their way forward. A disastrous shift in the wind which nullified the smoke screen lay bare the attackers to a murderous fire. Though a high toll of lives is taken, the Marines never falter. They enlarge their bridgehead and dig themselves in. Allied aircraft give constant support. The fighting leathernecks need all the help they can get. Braving the dangerous reefs, the warships close in to blast the stubborn Japs. With the enemy garrison virtually wiped out, supplies come ashore at a coconut log pier, where a few hours before, the Marines' beachhead was a strip just 20 feet wide between water and Jap machine guns. But the Marines kept on coming under deadly fire, and every man who fell had had his shot at the enemy. Finally, more Japs than Americans lay dead. The thin strip expanded and grew until it dominated the entire enemy stronghold. Barbed wire to delay attackers under a withering fire. Bomb-proof concrete dugouts on the shore. Inside this massive pillbox are dead Japs, many killed in hand-to-hand combat. A wrecked enemy gun, one of those which vigorously answered the Navy shelling. General MacArthur admits frankly that Japanese strength at Tarawa was greater than expected. We have learned much about the power and the weaknesses of the Jap in this war. The lesson will continue as the Allies smash into his important defenses. The Japs on Tarawa were strong, well-prepared, and skillful. Notwithstanding this terrific destruction, it took all the Marines had to win. Korean workers make up all but a handful of enemy prisoners on Tarawa. Marines have learned to shoot to kill. 6,000 Japs were killed against a loss of 1,026 Marines. It was the bloodiest battle of the Pacific War. On Tarawa's beach, a wounded Marine receives a blood transfusion. Their casualties in 76 hours of fighting were greater than in 6 months on Guadalcanal. In the other islands that make up the Gilbert group, the army is firmly entrenched. The Marines have brought the Allies an important step nearer the heart of Japan. They have lived up to a glorious tradition. the situation is well in hand.